That's one of a thousand questions I want the team to answer.
Team?
Yes. I've organized an expedition to go in and thank you and document them to make the most spectacular living fossil record the world's ever seen.
John, okay, so there's another island with dinosaurs, no fences this time, and you want to send people in, very few people, on the ground, right? And who are these four lunatics that you're trying to con into this?
There's Nick Van Owen, who's a video documentarian, and Eddie Carr, who's a field equipment expert. We have our paleontologist, and I was hoping that perhaps you might be the fourth.
John? No. Of course. No. And I'm going to contact the other three members of your team, and I'm going to stop them from going. Who's the paleontologist, by the way?
You didn't say
she came to me. I want you to know this.
Who did?
Leave it to you, Ian, to have associations, affiliations, even liaisons with the best people in so many fields.
You didn't contact Sarah.
Paleontological behavior study is a brand new field, and Sarah Harding is on that frontier.
No.
Her theories on parenting and nurturing amongst carnivores has framed the debate.
Well, it's not a research expedition anymore. It's a rescue operation, and it's leaving right now.
Can't shave 3 days off my deadline, expect everything to be ready. I'm not fully supplied. I haven't field tested any of this stuff.
What's the point in giving her a satellite phone if it doesn't work? What is the matter with this?
It could be anything. Could be solar flare. Satellite could be out of sync. Maybe she even turned it off. I need half air on the tires here, guys. Flying pressure is half air.
Know how to use it?
What, are you kidding? She's faxed me refinements on 50% of the plans for this stuff. Don't do that. Don't do that. You got a baby in a little bit. You got to love it.
I'll love it when it works.
It'll work when you love it. Let me do it.
Come along, eh?
I don't usually. I don't like to feel very much, but in this case,
thanks for the 2-minute warning, Eddie.
Nick Van Owen. This is Ian Malcolm. Nick's our field photographer.
How do you
Ian's
do?
Our.
How do you do?
How do you do? Ian.
What's your background? Wildlife photography?
Yeah, wildlife, combat, you name it. When I was with Nightline, I was in Rwanda, Chechnya, all over Bosnia. Thanks. Do some volunteer work with Greenpeace once in a while.
Greenpeace? What drew you there?
Women. 80% female Greenpeace.
That's noble.
Yeah. Well, noble was last year. This year I'm getting paid. Hammond's check cleared. Or I wouldn't be going on this wild goose chase.
Where you're going is the only place in the world where the geese chase you.
How are we doing here?
Specs say it can't deform at 12,000 PSI, so we just gotta test it.
Okay, well, let's clear. Are we clear?
What is that?
It's a high hide. A high hide. You know, you go up and you hide. Hide. Goes up to where the trees are. And it keeps the researchers out of harm's way, you know.
Actually, they put him at a very convenient biting height. What's the time? Do you have the time?
Do I have the time? Why?
We're leaving in 3 hours.
What, 3 hours?
Strat air rifle. Fires a subsonic Pfluger impact delivery dart.
Does it work any better than your satellite phone?
That's funny. I loaded it with the enhanced venom of Conus pepper acid, Salcy cone shell. Most powerful neurotoxin in the world acts within a 2,000th of a second, which is faster than the nerve conduction velocity. So the animal's down before it even feels the prick of the dart.
Is there an antidote?
What do you mean, like if you shot yourself in the foot? Don't do that. You'd be dead before you even realized you had an accident.
The guy says that he wants to unload at the shore right here. He won't go any further up the river. He's heard too many stories about this island chain, and he wants to drop us off and go anchor somewhere offshore.
What kind of stories?
¿Qué tipo de cuentos?
Los de pescadores, que se sacaron demasiado las islas y nunca volvieron.
Sí, 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 these are stories of fishermen that came too close to the island and then never returned.
Tengo la radio, tengo el teléfono satélite.
Sí, he has the radio, he has the satellite phone.
Cuando necesitan, llámame. Podemos llegar en dos horas.
Right, when you need him, send the call and he'll be here in 2 hours.
No me quedaré en este lugar.
But he will not stay here.
No me quedaré en ningún lugar cerca de estas islas.
He won't stay anywhere near these islands.
Se llaman las cinco muertes.
They call the islands las cinco muertes.
Sí.
What does that mean?
The five deaths, he says.
Location sensor into Dr. Harding's satellite phone, so we should be getting a reading.
Yeah, I'm so relieved.
My button is okay, William Morty.
Almost
time.
On top of her dodge, she should be right. Around here.
Over there.
How many Sarahs do you think are on this island?
Sarah!
Seth!
Starts, but then later there's running and screaming.
Wow.
You got the jump on us here a little bit, didn't you, Sarah?
Yeah. Ian, I never thought in a million years how I'm going to get you to come here. Hey, Eddie.
Hi, Sarah.
You got a granola bar or something? I'm starving. Those animals just walked by. Did you see them? It's a family group. A pair bond and a sub-adult long after the juvenile was nest found. Every egg clutch I've seen has got shells crushed. And trample, the hatchlings definitely stay in the birth environment for an extended period of time. That's conclusive. I can put that controversy to rest if I can just get a shot of the nest.
You haven't been attacked?
Oh, no. That's my lucky pack. That's how it always looks.
Okay, Sarah.
Is that an icon?
Yeah.
Can I borrow that? I'll be right back, baby. I promise. Stay there. Be quiet. Be right back.
Sarah, no, no! No.
Stay there.
Once she sees something, she's got it.
Is this even possible?
What? This? What do you think you were going to document? What do you think you were going to see?
Animals? Maybe, big iguanas?
protecting their baby, so am I.
They're leaving. I think they're leaving. Wow.
These images are incredible, legendary. Wow. Guys shoot their whole life, they never get stuff half this good.
Wow.
I mean, you can give me the Pulitzer right now, today, please.
Wow.
Competition's over, close the entries. I'd like to thank everybody who lost.
I don't like that. Dinosaurs can pick up scents from miles away. We're here to observe and document, not interact.
Ian, don't be mad. I was going to call you in a day or two to let you know where I was. I always do, don't I? Come on. I'm the best kind of girlfriend there is. One who travels a lot. You like that, right? You love me.
Well, I've gotten used to being apart, but that doesn't mean that's how I want to live.
Hey. I know what I'm doing. You guys should definitely go. But I'm going to stay. I love you. I just don't need you right now.
I'll tell you what you need. A good antipsychotic.
I'll be back in 5 or 6 days.
No, you'll be back in 5 or 6 pieces.
What bothers you is that I'm not afraid of this place, and you are.
Of course I am. That's the whole thing.
I don't get that.
It says InGen on the side of that chopper. I don't get that. Why would Hammond send 2 teams?
Doesn't he trust us? We haven't even started.
This is as good a place as any for base camp. That's first priority after we're finished. I want it up and running in 30 minutes. That's half an hour. Understood? Over.
Cancel that order.
What? Why?
This is a game trail, Mr. Ludlow. Carnivores hunt on game trails. Do you want to set up base camp or a buffet?
Let's find a new spot, shall we? Over and out.
Peter, if you want me to run your little camping trip, there are 2 conditions. Firstly, I'm in charge, and when I'm not around, Dieter is. All you need to do is sign the checks, tell us we're doing a good job, and open your case of scotch when we have a good day. Second condition, my fee. You can keep it. All I want in exchange for my services is the right to hunt one of the tyrannosaurs. A male. A buck only. How and why are my business. Now, if you don't like either of those 2 conditions, you're on your own. So go ahead. Set up base camp right here, or in a swamp, or in the middle of a wreck's nest, for all I care. But I've been on too many safaris with rich dentists to listen to any more suicidal ideas. Okay.
Okay.
Stay ready. He's bringing them out to you.
It'll be a packy. Oh hell! The fat head with the bald spot. Fry it up.
Fry Tok's on the loose, just about to cross your path.
Your leg! Watch the tag!
Bert! Come here!
You recognize this trackway?
Yes, I do. Tyrannosaur.
To collect my fee, Mr. Ludlow, to collect my fee.
Oh my God. It's Agathis Triassicus, found by Frost in Bavaria in 1913.
Is it dangerous?
I wouldn't think so. Compi's been presumed to be scavengers, like jackals.
Gives me the creeps. It's like it's not scared.
There haven't been any visitors to this island. There's no reason for it to fear man.
Now it does.
Won't leave him alone for too long.
Let your blind here. Wait for the buck to
return. No. The nest is upwind, and so are we. When he comes back, he's gonna know we're here without us even having a chance. The trick is to get him to come where we want him.
Tell you guys, Hammond told me these people might show up. I thought we'd be finished by the time they got started, but in case they weren't, he did send a backup plan.
What backup plan?
Me.
That's the last time I leave you in charge.
God! Are you out of your mind?
He's got a broken leg. Let's get in the car before they hear us.
Are you out of your mind? Do you have any idea what that is?
Come on, open the door.
You're nuts.
That's it. Man, Ian's not gonna like this.
What's going on?
Isn't it obvious? We're not alone on this island.
What the hell is that?
I'll get him. I got it.
Hurry up, Nick.
Let's go. Go. Come on. Watch his tail. Get the door open.
Oh, no. This is nothing like that. We're in a completely different situation right now.
Hey, is there any way we can communicate with the trailers?
He's moving again. Give him more morphine.
We have no idea what his metabolism is. To kill him with too much, we'll put him into respiratory arrest. Nick, I need your hand here. Right here. Put some pressure there.
No answer. What a surprise. How do I get down?
Tie this belt around you.
Would it kill you to pick it up? Help me get this thing out of here.
No, we just have to...
Mommy's very angry. People listen to me. I use plain, simple English. I don't have any accent that I'm wearing.
Oh, shut up.
So that should make an interesting chapter in your book, huh?
I think that the debate over the parental instincts of the T-Rex is now academic.
Hang on, this is gonna be bad. Pushing us over the cliff.
Oh my God.
Come on. Let's go out of here.
Straight into the woods.
Straight into the woods.
Come on.
This is where they're gonna see you.
Hang on to something!
Anything else?
Yeah, 3 double cheeseburgers with everything.
No onions on mine.
I don't know, we'll turn it over.
Destroyed. Well, if your radio and satellite phone were in those trailers that went over the cliff...
They were.
Then we're stuck here, ladies and gentlemen, and stuck together, thanks to you people.
And we came here to watch. You came to strip mine the place. Back off.
At least we came prepared. Since you
prepared,
destroyed all our equipment.
About 5 years of work and 100 miles of electrified fence couldn't prepare the other island. Did you think that, what, a couple dozen Marlboro men would make a difference here?
It's a looter mentality. All you care about is what you can take. You have no rights.
An extinct animal that's brought back to life has no rights. It exists because we made it. We patented it. We own it.
Are you looking for a problem?
I found you, didn't I?
Oh. Hey, come on!
I know you. You're that Earth First bastard, aren't you?
Earth First, what's that?
Provisional saboteur.
What, firemen!
Criminals!
Knock it off! Listen to me! By moving the baby Rex into our camp, we may have changed the adult perceived territory.
The what?
That's why they persisted in destroying the trailers.
and they'll feel they have to defend this entire area.
We have to move right now.
Move where? Our boat, their airlift, they're both waiting for an order. We have no way to send.
All right, all right. There's a communications center here at the near the old operations building. Hammond ran everything on geothermal power. It was never meant to need replenishing. If we can get here, we can send a radio call for the airlift.
Is that the frequency written down somewhere?
Right here in this book.
Well, we'll mind those.
All right, how far is the village?
A day's walk, maybe more. That's not the problem.
What is? What is the problem?
Velociraptors. Our infrared show that their nesting sites are concentrated in the island interior, which is why we plan to keep to the upper rim.
Wait a minute. What's that? Velociraptor. Carnivore. Pack hunter. About 2 meters tall, long snout, binocular vision, strong dexterous forearms, and killing claws on both feet.
And the Rexes may continue to track us, too, if they perceive a threat to themselves or to their infants.
No, you're wrong there, Dr. Harding. We'll lose them once we leave their territory.
No, don't bet on it. Tyrannosaurus got the largest proportional olfactory cavity of any creature in the fossil record, with the exception of one.
Right, turkey vulture could scent up to 10 miles.
Right. This is all very thrilling, but I say we should push on to the village.
We could head back down to the lagoon.
And do what? Sit out in the open? Next to a heavily used water source and hope that your captain decides to come back for you?
He won't do that. He knows better.
Then we head for the village. We might find some shelter, and we can call for help. Rex just fed, so he won't stalk us for food.
Just fed? I assume you're talking about Eddie? You might show a little respect. The man saved our lives by giving his...
Then his troubles are over. My point is, the predators don't hunt when they're not hungry.
No, only humans do.
Oh, you're breaking our hearts. Saddle up! Let's get this movable feast underway. Take a break. 5 minutes.
Hey, Carter, I'm going to the ladies' room. So you wait for me here, yeah, okay?
Mi llorona, mi llorona.
Oh, man.
Okay, break over. Moving on.
Carter. Carter.
When did you last see him?
10-15 minutes.
Come with me. And you. If he's alive, we'll find him. The rest of you keep right on. 10 minutes, you should reach the ridge. Wait for us there.
Right. Let's carry on. Everybody, up. Come on. Up, up, up.
All right, guys. Let's get the hell out of here.
Yeah. Right.
You find him?
Just the parts they didn't like. Map. The operations building is right down in there, about a mile and a half from the base of these cliffs.
How do you know that?
I've seen it. Now, the climb down won't be easy. We'll let them sleep one more hour, and then we hit it.
It's coming back!
RJ's back. Go. As fast as you can. Go. Structure's there. Okay, they said the communication center is in the operations building. So I'll get in there and I'll send the radio call, all right? I'll see you there.
Wait for us.
Every second counts. Anyone thinks they can keep up, welcome to try.
Okay, here it comes.
No, Ian, rest.
CQ, this is Engine Operations Harvest Leader to Harvest Base. Repeating, I'm calling for Engine Operations Harvest Leader seeking Engine Harvest Base.
Go ahead, Harvest.
Yeah, the operation has suffered severe casualties, and the survivors are now in mortal danger. I need you to send rescue immediately. Our coordinates here are 9 degrees, 58 minutes north, 85 degrees...
Nick? Nick Van Owen? Nick? Here! Inside, anywhere!
Where the nest is. I want it on my jet and take it directly to the infirmary complex in San Diego. And hurry it up. I'd love to be airborne before the female knows we're here. Oh, Roland! Roland! You probably saved Ingen. We lost everything we came after on this trip, but this animal single-handedly bailed us out.
Congratulations.
You've got your trophy! Buck only! But it's alive! And everyone on the planet's going to line up to appreciate it and everything you've done for us. What's the matter?
He didn't make it. RJ.
I'm sorry.
Really? I am. You know, I remember the people that helped me, Roland. There's a job for you at the park in San Diego if you want it.
No, thank you.
I believe I've spent enough time in the company of death.
Are you there? There you are.
One souvenir they won't be taking with them.
crew has come forward just to keep the island itself intact.
It is absolutely imperative that we work with the Costa Rican Department of Biological Preserves to establish a set of rules for the preservation and isolation of that island. These creatures require our absence to survive, not our help. And if we could only step aside and trust in nature, life